Okay, so I'm here with Billy Bowden on the eve of the Lord's Test, and you're going to make a little bit of umpiring history with Tony Hill by being the first neutral umpires from the same country to oversee a match. How does it feel to be part of umpiring history?
Oh, first of all, it's just great to be umpiring at Lord's. That's number one. But that surprised us because we thought over the last 6 or 7 years there would have been a couple of neutral umpires from different countries. But to have Tony on the elite panel and myself and umpiring for the first time together overseas and at Lord's, it's going to be a special occasion. And we both are proud to be Kiwis, and I'm sure that when we walk out there, we're going to be just as proud just to come and we'll come together and umpire together at the home of home cricket.
Brilliant, brilliant. And do you have any of the special memories, particularly at Lord's itself, especially with this Test match being at Lord's?
Every special Test that I do is unique in their own way. This is my third Test at Lord's. I remember my first Test at Lord's was against South Africa, and that was a special time, mainly because it's my first Test, and I wanted my parents to be there, my mum and dad, but unfortunately my mum passed away a couple of months before. So that was a special time, a sad time, but a really happy time as well.
And I've been talking to the England cricket fans online, and so they've come up with a few questions. One of which they're intrigued to know about the cricket finger. Is there a story behind that, or is there a reason for that?
Well, when I started, I had arthritis, and that's why I stopped playing the game. And I thought I could make a difference to challenge myself against the best players around, and to make a difference to umpiring. And because of arthritis, my fingers were sore and they were achy, so I couldn't straighten them a lot of the time. So the easy way is just to give the crooked finger, and since then it's stuck. So players know that when the finger goes up, they have to walk. Sometimes they don't want to walk, but they've got to. And some players think they're only half out because I've only given them half out. But that's the way it is, and that's the way I express myself, and it's natural, and what you see is what you get. Yeah.
Do you see the role of umpires sort of evolving in the future? Has you seen the game change since you started umpiring?
Yeah, it's become far more professional, and far more pressure on umpires. I think umpires today work really hard, well, they have to. Players do. Umpires have to do. They have to become better at the game. You just can't take the game for granted. You've got to respect the game and make sure that you do your best you can and become the best umpire you can be. And that's by working hard, not just on the field, but off the field as well.
And so what's the process you go through as an umpire, sort of evaluating the decisions you make throughout a game? What's that off-field process after a game, for example?
You don't want to kind of hit yourself time and time again, because the game's not perfect. The ball's not quite round, and players make mistakes and umpires make mistakes. I mean, you don't go out there trying to make mistakes. You just got to focus on one ball at a time, and if you do make a mistake, you just got to park it and just focus on the next ball, because the next ball is the most important ball. So you evaluate yourself after the game. You do the best you can at that time, and you make sure that you don't try to make that mistake again. And it's all about being in the zone and making sure that you're there at the right time, at the right place.
And how do you prepare for before a match? You mentioned you know you have to get to the top of your game. Do you do any specific things, say, before this test here? Are you doing anything specific tomorrow, for example?
No, it's another game. It's a special game, but it's just a game of cricket. And you just go through your routines. I like to go to the gym leading up to the test match. I like to read my playing conditions and the laws, just to have that confidence knowing if the what-if happens, that you're there for yourself, but also there for your colleague, so the players can respect you even more by being confident when you're making your decisions. And just to visualise who you're umpiring against, who the players are, the batsmen and the bowlers, and just having a relaxed attitude. And when you walk out on that field, across that rope, that you've done your best you can, you've prepared the best you can, and you plan the best you can, and you're going to get out there and do the best you can. And that's all you can do.
Definitely. And do you have any advice for any new umpires, any younger umpires, or any new umpires coming through and becoming umpires for the first time?
You've got to enjoy it. It's hard to say to enjoy a game because there's so much pressure and there's a lot of people criticising you for what you do. But you've got to be happy within yourself. You've got to be a happy umpire. And to be natural and to always do your best, to work hard, make no excuses, make sure that you respect the game, you respect the players, and you respect your colleagues, and you respect your fellow umpires. And if you do that, then you can process further. But the one big thing I would say is to admit your mistakes. Don't make excuses. Admit your mistakes. Say, yep, what did I do wrong? Look at it. Listen to people. And then learn. So look, listen, and learn. If you do those three, then you can make progress.
Great. Thank you, Billy. I wish you all the best of luck on Thursday and for the final Lords test.
You little beauty. Thanks very much.